I had always been doing art in parallel with my engineering, math, and science studies. Art, I think, is a compulsion and something I've sort of always done and I have to do. To me, there's no huge distinction between artwork and building robots or artwork and building AI systems. I guess I had always been on a sort of non-traditional, weird trajectory. I'd say my art is mostly about how humans and technologies are co-evolving together. Sometimes looking at where we've been and definitely looking at where we're going and trying to point out some of the inevitable connections we have with what's around us in machines or social interactions we have with computers. My thesis work at the Media Lab was this robot called Boxy.
I need help.
Boxy was a social robot autonomous filmmaker, and it would travel around being cute, and it would ask people questions to try to elicit responses. And I would say that's sort of the kernel of where I began my studies in human machine interaction, human machine collaboration. Using a system which is collaborating with me to create these images. The way it gets there is interesting and sometimes hard to follow. It's more about the conceptual process of it pulling body signals out for me. So I have a subset of these amalgam images, which are ones that are creepy, and they're usually like eyes and faces and things and dark alleys and stuff. And I think that's because the same signals that were like my excitement or interest in an image that showed up also picked up on the fear response or like the creepy response. The technology I use with my art is always changing. I'd say every time I build something, I learn something new, either a new technology or I learn about a new robot component or something. And you know, building up your toolbox of items you can use is like, you know, building up colors you can use to paint with. Art is a way to speak to an everyday person. Like if you have an interactive experience with a technologically-based artwork, you might be able to understand something like AI a bit more intuitively than you would, you know, reading a paper or reading a news article. I think it's important for people to think about technology because it's becoming ever more integrated into who we are.